Ethinylestradiol is an estradiol used as a contraceptive. In this video, let's find found. What is ethinylestradiol? What is ethinylestradiol used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking ethinylestradiol? How does ethinylestradiol work? How to use ethinylestradiol? What is ethinylestradiol? Ethinylestradiol, EE, is an estrogen medication which is used widely in birth control pills in combination with progestins. In the past, EE was widely used for various indications such as the treatment of menopausal symptoms, gynecological disorders, and certain hormone sensors. It is usually taken by mouth, but is also used as a patch and vaginal ring. EE was developed in the 1930s and was introduced for medical use in 1943. The medication started being used in birth control pills in the 1960s. Today, EE is in almost all combined forms of birth control pills and is nearly the exclusive estrogen used for this purpose, making it one of, if not the most widely used estrogens. What is ethinylestradiol used for? Ethinylestradiol is combined with other drugs for use as a contraceptive, premenstrual dysphoric disorder, moderate acne, moderate to severe vasomotor symptoms of menopause, prevention of postmenopausal osteoporosis. Contraindication. EE should be avoided in individuals with a history of or known susceptibility to arterial or venous thrombosis, blood clots, due to an increased risk of cardiovascular problems such as venous thromboembolism, VTE, myocardial infarction, and ischemic stroke. Side effects. General side effects of EE are the same as for other estrogens and include breast tenderness, headache, fluid retention, bloating, nausea, dizziness, and weight gain. The estrogen component of oral contraceptives, which is almost always EE, can cause breast tenderness and fullness. In males, EE has additional side effects, including gynecomastia, breast development, feminization in general, hypogonadism, infertility, and sexual dysfunction, example, reduced libido and erectile dysfunction. In men who received high-dose estrogen therapy with 200 mg/day oral EE more than 3 months, gynecomastia occurred in 98% and decreased libido occurred in 42-73%. Pharmacodynamic. Ethinylestradiol is a synthetic estrogen that decreases luteinizing hormone to decrease endometrial vascularization and decreases gonadotrophic hormone to prevent ovulation. It has a long duration of action as it is taken once daily, and a wide therapeutic index as overdoses are generally not associated with serious adverse effects. Patients should be counseled regarding the risks of thrombotic events. Mechanism of action. Ethinylestradiol is a synthetic estrogenic compound. Use of estrogens have a number of effects on the body, including reduced bone density. Combined oral contraceptives suppress ovulation by suppressing gonadotrophic hormone, thickening cervical mucus to prevent the travel of sperm, and preventing changes in the endometrium required for implantation of a fertilized egg. Ethinylestradiol decreases luteinizing hormone, decreasing vascularity in the endometrium. It also increases sex hormone binding globulin. Half-life. A 30 g oral dose has a half-life of 8.4 ± 4.8 h, and a 1.2 mg topical dose has a half-life of 27.7 ± 34.2 h. Dose. Female hypogonadism. Adult, 10-50 micrograms daily, usually on a cyclical basis. Initial estrogen therapy should be followed by a combined estrogen and progestogen therapy. Postmenopausal symptoms due to estrogen deficiency. Adult, 10-50 micrograms daily for 21 days, repeated after a 7-day tablet-free period, to be given with a progestogen for 12-14 days per cycle in women with an intact uterus or an endometriosis when endometrial foci may be present despite hysterectomy. Not recommended to add a progestogen in women without a uterus who did not have endometriosis diagnosed. Prophylaxis of osteoporosis in postmenopausal women. Adult, in women at high risk of future fractures who are intolerant of, or contraindicated for, other osteoporosis preventing therapies, 10 to 50 micrograms daily for 21 days, repeat after a 7-day tablet-free period. To be given with a progestogen for 12 to 14 days per cycle in women with an intact uterus or an endometriosis when endometrial foci may be present despite hysterectomy. Not recommended to add a progestogen in women without a uterus who did not have endometriosis diagnosed. Palliative treatment of prostatic carcinoma. Adult, 150 to 1,500 micrograms daily. Menstrual disorders. Adult, 20 to 50 micrograms daily from day 5 to 25 of each cycle, given together with a progestogen, added either throughout the cycle or from day 15 to 25. Safety advice. FDA pregnancy category X, not for use in pregnancy. That's all the information about ethinylestradiol we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video to update more health information.